Maybe the last time, I don't know. This may be the last time. Maybe the last time, I don't know. I hear the angels all around my bedside. All around my bedside, all around my bedside, I hear the angels singing, this may be the last time, it may be the last time, I don't know, this may be the last time, it may be the last time. I don't know, this may be the last time, it may be the last time, I don't know. That is to rebuke the enemy.
Amen.
That is to take the spirit of death down.
Amen.
That is to rebuke Satan. God says, stand and rebuke death.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. The enemy wants us to be all scared of them.
Amen.
Because God brought us back. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord didn't say it was going to be easy, did he? He never said it's going to be easy.
That's right.
He said, as long as we're on this earth, we're going to have trials and tribulation. Amen.
Amen.
We'll be having them trials and tribulation.
Amen.
But we are supposed to stand like that tree. Let it out of river to water. And don't move, unless he says so. Don't move, unless he tell you so. And he knows them that hear him.
Amen.
He knows them that hear him. And do the opposite.
Amen.
And the Lord said, he's tired of it.
Come on now.
He's tired of it. The Lord chose somebody, a dog in the sky. And he says, that is me.
Amen.
Because my people got me like a leash. They're going to pull me which way they want to go.
Amen.
And he said, I am not a dog. I am their father,
yes.
Who are in heaven. This may be the last time. Come on, y'all. May it be the last time. I don't know. This may be the last time. Come on. This may be the last time. It may. Amen. It's an old song.
Amen.
And the Lord said, sing it.
Amen.
I want you to sing it and put the devil in his place.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now listen to this song. I'm running for my life.
I'm running for my life.
If anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Just tell them I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, and I got Jesus on my side.
I'm running for my life. I'm running for my life. Running.
Yeah. And Lord, we thank
And Lord, we thank you, my mouth, God, in the name of Jesus. And if someone have a pain in the left side also, Father God, Lord, I got to move that pain too. Come on, Lord Jesus, move that pain, my Father. In the name of Jesus, mm-hmm. Father God, this morning, my Father, as your word goes forward, my Father, just move on everyone in here, Father God, and move whatever pain, Father, in the name of Jesus, my Father God, and Lord thy God, and move on our eyes, Father, in the name of Jesus, my Father God, also, Lord thy God, and we thank you, my Father, and we praise you, Lord thy God, in the name of Jesus Christ, yes, my Father God. For Lord, you brought us here to serve you and to worship you, Father God, and give you the praise and give you the glory. Yes. And Lord, we're going to do it when we're here. We're going to do it when we're not here, Lord. We're going to do it in the middle of the day, my Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, Lord, we're going to keep our eyes upon you, Lord, that God. And not on the government, my Father God.
Amen.
And not on the people, my Father God.
Amen.
But you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we're going to hear your word, Father God. As you talk to us at nighttime, and as we pray to you, Father, and as we rise up in the morning, my Father God, and you give us the strength to go on, my Father. In the name of Jesus, Father God, we're going to listen to you, and our ears is going to be attended.
Yes, Lord.
To your voice.
Thank you, Father.
Lord, we thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Lord.
And we rebuke tiredness.
In the name of Jesus.
We rebuke tiredness, Father. Tiredness,
Lord.
Get that energy, Father. Come on, out of here. The energy.
Thank you, Father.
And I thank you, Father. And Lord Jesus, as you bring the prayers out of my mouth, you bring Deacon Sam to me, Father.
In the name of Jesus.
And Lord, we lift up his family to you on this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Lord Jesus, he lost his uncle, my father. And Lord, we ask you, my Father God, to move on the family.
In the name of Jesus.
To move on them, my Father God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father. And also, Father, we ask you to move on. Deaconess Lorda also, Father.
Amen.
But she lost her father, Lord, that God. And we was all at home, Lord, that God. I ask you, my Father God, to move all over her. And move all over her children.
Yes.
And move all over her sisters and brothers, my Father God. In the name of Jesus. And continue to move on our husband, my Father.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, Lord, just bless them, my Father. And as you take them day by day still, my Father, we give you the praise, Father God. For Lord, you are the shepherd, my
yes.
Father. And they shall not want. I rebuke the enemy try to come in at certain time, Father.
In the name of
Jesus. Because the devil's a liar.
Yes.
I rebuke that spirit. My Father,
in the name
of Jesus, Lord, we trust you.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
We trust you, Father, without a shadow of doubt.
Thank you, Father.
And you said in your word, if we love you, you said in your word, if we love you, then we will keep your commandment.
Yes,
Lord. And I love you with all our heart and all our might. And all our soul, Father God. And that means be obedient.
Thank you, Father.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. You think it's
Proverbs 15.
Big Proverbs 15. Down to the
15th.
Start at the first verse.
To the 15th.
To the 15th.
Amen.
Everyone have the Bible?
Amen.
Proverbs 15, starting at the first verse, and it reads, a soft answer turns away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger.
Read that again.
A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger.
Read it again.
A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge upright, but the mouth of fools pour out foolishness.
Read that again.
The tongue of the wise use knowledge upright, but the mouth of fools pour out foolishness. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit. He said, read that one again.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but the perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit. A fool despises his father's instruction, but he that regardeth reproof is prudent. A fool that despises his father's instruction, but he that regardeth reproof is prudent. In the house of the righteous is much treasure, but in the revenue of the wicked is trouble.
Amen.
The lips of the wise disperse knowledge, but the heart of the foolish doeth not so. The sacrifice of the wicked is an abomination to the Lord.
But
the sacrifice of the wicked is an abomination to the Lord.
Read that again.
The sacrifice of the wicked is an abomination to the Lord. But the prayers of the upright is his delight.
Amen. Read that again.
But the prayers of the upright is his delight.
Amen.
The way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord. But he that loveth him that followeth after righteousness. The way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord. But he that loveth him that follow after righteousness. Correction is grievous unto him that forsake the way. And he that hated reproof shall die.
Read that again, baby.
Correction is grievous unto him that forsaketh the way, and he that hateth reproof shall die. Hell and destruction are before the Lord. How much more then the hearts of children of men? Hell and destruction are before the Lord. How much more then the hearts of the children of men? A scorner loveth not one that reprove him, neither will he go unto the wise. A scorner loveth not one that reproves him, neither will he go unto the wise.
Amen.
A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, but by sorrow of the heart the spirit is broken. A merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, but by sorrow of the heart the spirit is broken. The heart of him that Amen. Have understanding
Amen.
Seeketh knowledge, but the mouth of fools feedeth on foolishness. 15 and last. All the days of the afflicted are evil, but he that is of a merry heart have a continual feast. All the days of the afflicted are evil, but he that is of a merry heart hath continual feast.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I go to 1 Corinthians. Amen. 1 Corinthians. Evangelist Latanya, he wants you to read this.
Amen.
Amen. He wants you to start from the 16th verse. Amen. And he did go to the 33. Ephesians chapter 1 Corinthians chapter 1. And start from the 16th verse. Okay, and go down to the 31st verse. Amen.
Amen.
Your legs all right out there.
Amen. Amen.
Are they standing strong?
Yes.
Yes.
For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach.
not with wisdom or words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God.
Now read it again.
For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God.
Amen.
For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputer of this world? Hath not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in the wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. For the Jews require a sign, and Greeks seek after wisdom. But we preach Christ crucified unto the Jews, a stumbling block, and unto the Greeks, foolishness. But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. For ye see your calling, brethren.
Earth. He created everything on this earth. And he
himself alone knows what's going on. It's the government come to take over God's job. Amen? Amen. The government come to take over the job of the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
That's why God always tells us to trust him. No matter what comes, no matter how hard it is, he said trust him. And hear his voice, not the government. Amen? Because they will take you the wrong way. Amen. A lot of time, even right now, they are right. But a whole lot of time, they are wrong.
Yes,
the Lord told me after this thing is over, we're going to be amazed what's come out. That what they say to do, they're going to say, well, you didn't have to do it. Okay, but they was running them tap.
Yes,
God already know.
Yeah. Amen.
He already know. And he will keep us informed of what's going on.
Thank you, Lord.
And to what to do. But we got to hearken unto him. Amen? Amen? But the government, that government came over that TV and he had people running so fast out of the stores and everything, trying to get everything out, and they were out there fighting in the stores. I mean, fighting. One lady got a whole lot of towels, toilet paper, the other lady didn't get in it, and she was trying to get some of this woman, and it's all fighting over it. Right there in the store. Amen? That's how bad it has gotten, and it's all over the world. I mean, all over the world. Amen? But God was trying to warn us. Amen? He was trying to tell us, amen, a long time ago, walk in obedience. Trials and tribulations. He tells us to be strong in our own trials and tribulations as we go through. All right? He said, call them minor. Minor. What we go through, what we go through, and we take our own self through, because sometimes when God says do one thing, we do another.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
When he said do one thing, amen, we do another thing. And that's what makes it so hard. So when things come on like this right here, amen, and if your body, if your spirit, if your flesh is not dead, amen, we're going to run after the enemy. Amen? Yes, we are. Yes, we are. You know why we're going after the enemy? Because it's his ways is easier than ours. Amen? Come on now. Come on, don't get too wild on me.
Yeah.
His way, I'm going to say it again.
Amen.
His way, flew foot, his way is easier. Our way is hard. And I can say it, because God take me to the east, to the west, to the north, to the south, then bring it back, then start me all over again. Amen.
Amen.
And it's not easy, but I do it. I got to do it. Amen. I got to do it. Amen? It is not, but we have to, and that's how he trained us. He trained us hard. He trained me hard, and he is training you all hard, but you're going this way and that way, then you come back. We got to stand and go to the training, because you know we are in the army.
Amen.
We are in the army.
Amen.
Of the Lord. Read that first verse, honey, of Proverbs.
Proverbs 15, first verse reads, a soft answer turneth away wrath.
A soft answer turneth away wrath. What does it mean?
But grievous words stir up anger.
But grievous words stir up anger.
Yes.
A soft answer turneth away wrath.
Yes.
And Lord, lead us in everything. Because if you're talking to someone, and if you're trying to break something down to someone, then the person don't understand what you're talking about. And let me know that they don't understand. Amen. Then some people want to get sort of icky.
Amen.
Amen. Come on now. When we are church, we are family.
Amen.
Amen. And when someone is trying to explain something to you, amen, and you don't understand what they are saying, amen, God will give you the answer to give to them if you let him.
Amen.
Amen. That's the kind of God we serve.
Yes.
But if we won't get our own belly in there and stop using our own flesh,
amen,
it's going to be hell.
Yes.
Amen. Because why? The flesh come from the enemy. The flesh. Instead of us listening to what the people are saying to us, try to understand. But sometimes we just mourn and just don't want to hear what they're talking about.
Amen.
Because of this and because of that. And then we got flip-flopping and turning ourselves around and hitting things and beating up things and everything. Amen. And then here comes the war between one another.
Amen.
God said, New Jerusalem ain't going to have that no more.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Because God said he's going to teach his people. And he means he's going to teach his people.
Amen.
How to commune with one another.
Amen.
Without always fighting and everything. Amen. And I don't care who it is because there's nothing too hard for the Lord.
That's right. Amen.
And especially, you know, as a pulpit, as a head, and as a sister pastor, amen. Amen. Sometimes you try to explain something to him or to me, and he might not understand the right way, but he don't know where you're going. Amen. He's trying to listen, he don't understand. Well, you got to stand there and just repeat it. Just have another soft answer. And he will respond.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. 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 Same thing for a deacon who's talking to somebody else who's not a deacon.
Amen.
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 Trying to break things down. Same thing for evangelists.
Amen.
Who's trying to break something down. God has them in charge of this, they have in charge of that. Just try to stand and break things down to them. All right? We don't get all huffed and puffed and turn away and want to run.
Amen.
It's too much money. Amen.
Amen.
We got to fight.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost way.
Amen.
And that's wisdom.
Amen.
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 Read it.
Second verse?
Yeah.
Amen. The tongue of the wise uses knowledge upright, but the mouth of fools pour out foolishness.
The tongue of the wise. The tongue. Well, who is the wise? The tongue of the wise. Who is the wise? Amen.
Okay.
You know, they're saved. Some people look at it. They're saved. It's unsaved.
Amen.
They would say sometimes an unsaved person is more wiser than a saved person.
Amen.
Amen. It hadn't got out there. They will say that. Sometimes an unsaved person is wiser than a saved person. Why? I'm going to tell you about it. Amen.
Amen.
Because a saved person, now, I'm not talking about a righteous person.
Amen.
A saved person. A saved person. Can be saved and not righteous.
Amen.
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 Sometimes a person can be saved, and not righteous. Because if they're not walking up on righteousness and being obedient to the Lord,
amen.
That's the only way they get the right answer.
Amen.
And then sometimes God will give them grace and mercy and give it to them. Amen. But it's unsaved. person sometimes is more humble. You know, that's their natural way. Like there's some good people who are just naturally good and everything. They have nice personality, good personality, everything. And they help out before somebody is really truly saved, or a saved person. I look at that, I ain't touching that. I'm not going to do this and that. That's a saved person. We're going to be righteous. Amen.
Amen.
But this person is not saved, but is a good person. Amen. He or she will come there, see a person lying in the street, and will humble and help when a saved person, now they say, the scripture speak of this. Amen. Will walk back, look down at that person, and walk away.
Amen.
In this dispensation, be very fearful. But I say this right here. When God in the midst of it, if God say help that person, bend down and help that person, we are to bend down and help.
Yes.
But if the Lord say you keep on going, you better keep on going.
Amen.
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 Amen. That's the difference. We hear God. Amen. And like I said, a good person will stop. But God will guide that good person also. Because God be God. Amen. It's calling to the heart. Amen. You understand what God is saying to you?
Amen.
Amen. We have to take heed to what the word said. But when God speaks to us and tell us, don't do it, we cannot do it, and don't even try to do it. Just keep on going. Amen. We are in the last days, and we're going to get a whole lot of this and a whole lot of that. And God is preparing them for all that.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
Be the next person.
Amen. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit.
A wholesome tongue. If you let the Holy Ghost tame your tongue. Because
yeah.
See, we can't tame this tongue here. Amen. We cannot tame our own tongue. No, we can't. God got to tame his tongue. For our tongue to be tamed, God got to tame it. Amen. And that is being obedient and speak when he said speak and keep your mouth closed when he said stay closed.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to say it again. God will tame his tongue right here. And that thing he said speak, I want you to say this. That you're in a conversation with some people, amen. And they are talking, and you want to talk to, and God said, don't say nothing. But then it gets so good, the conversation gets so good, you just got to bring it on out anyway, amen. You just get so good, Yeah, I mean, and then just be bubbling up and all in you. You just got to get it out. You just got to get it out. And so you go ahead and Lord and bring it out. He don't want that.
Amen,
Father. It also teaches us patience.
Yes.
So we got to have patience. We be still and tell him, he says, speak. Mm-hmm. And then we will speak. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Go ahead, honey. Go to the next verse.
A fool despises his father's instructions.
A fool. Mm-hmm. A fool.
Yes.
You hear a lot of fool in Proverbs.
Mm-hmm.
You hear a whole lot of fool. Amen.
Amen.
A fool despises what?
His father's instructions.
His father's instructions. So what is God is saying to us about that? Amen. If we despise what he is telling us, we are despising his ways because we don't like his ways. Amen.
Amen.
He called us a fool. Amen.
Amen.
If we don't like the ways of the Lord, and we have to be honest with him because you know where we're like. Amen. If we don't like the ways of him, because it got to be his way, not our way.
Amen.
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 We always humble and do it anyway. Now, I ain't going to stand up here and say I like everything that the Lord do. I'm not going to stand here and say that. I stay obedient and I keep his commandments. But if I sit on this pulpit and say, oh, I love all the ways of the Lord. Oh, yes, I do, because I love the Lord. I love the Lord. But I don't like all of his ways. Amen.
Amen.
But I sure stay in order with him.
Amen.
Amen. Don't have no choice. Don't have no choice. Amen. Just like when your mother was raising me up. And she tell you to go somewhere and you don't want to go. Well, you got to go. Don't have no choice. Amen. I don't have no choice. And I don't be rebellious against him.
Amen.
I just humble. And that's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to humble no matter what he tell us. And sometimes it don't make sense. No, it don't make sense.
Amen.
But we are to humble to the Lord.
Amen.
Humble to his instruction when he tells us we want us to go to some place. And humble to him when he tells us to get up and leave because it's time to leave now. Get up and leave.
Right.
Amen. But do we get up and leave? No, we stay up for another hour. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
We sit down there for another hour, all right, steady talking, and then he has to repeat himself. I want you to go now.
Amen.
I want you to go. Oh, that is so important because God has given us an order.
Yes.
And we don't do it. See, because God is tearing down the brush.
Amen.
Amen. Because when you disobey God, you feed in the brush. And the brush must die. And the spirits come in your body. Amen. And take over, take control. And sometimes you don't even know the devil.
Amen.
Amen. Read the next verse.
Amen. I didn't finish that one, so.
Go ahead.
Amen.
A fool despises his father's instruction, but he that regardeth reproof is prudent.
Reproof.
Yes.
It's prudent.
Yes.
Reproof.
Yes.
Reproof. Correction. We prove, and we know, being honest, you don't like to be corrected, but we receive it anyway. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the Lord always have me correct somebody.
Yeah.
Amen. Do I like it all the time? No. But I got to do it because he said do it.
Yes.
And I will do it with a blinking of an eye.
Amen.
But do I like it? Do I like it? No. But when God tell me, you got to correct that. And I see that finger pointing out there. Yes, I'm going to correct it. But do I like it? All right? Because see, sometimes I say, well, I like the word of God. I like how God is doing things. Some things I do. A whole lot of things I do and some things I don't. Amen? God wants us to be honest with him. The basic thing that God wants is us to be honest with him. And not be a phony with him.
Amen.
He wants us to be honest and not phony. Amen?
Amen.
Be honest with him and not phony because he knows us. So how can we be phony with him when we know that he knows us?
Amen.
Tell the truth and say the devil is that.
That's right.
Amen.
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 In the house of righteousness is much treasure, but in the revenues of the wicked is trouble.
Read that again, honey.
In the house of righteousness is much treasure, but in the revenues of the wicked is trouble.
Read that again.
In the house of righteousness,
in the house of righteousness
is much treasure.
Is much treasure. Stir up us.
Thank you, Lord.
Much treasure. Much blessing.
Yes.
In the house of God's people, and sometimes we don't even know it.
Amen.
Amen. In the house of God's people, there is much treasure. And we don't know it. It is stirred up for us.
Thank you. Go ahead and read it.
Amen. But in the revenues of the wicked is trouble.
In the wicked? Okay, Father. And sometimes in the house of God, there can be a lot of wicked people. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
There can be a lot of wicked people, And sometimes you don't even know they'll be there.
Amen.
Amen. They be right up in your nose and don't know that they'll be there because wow, they're in the house of the Lord. So if they're there by the house of the Lord, it's good. Satan comes and says that he hides, man. Pretend like he's so sanctified and holy. That man came in here and stood at that door.
Amen.
On Thursday. Mm-hmm. Amen. And God told me that was going to happen.
Amen.
And he stood. And he looked. Mm-hmm. And then Deacon Judy spoke to him. She knew it. But he came to be nosy. Mm-hmm. But then he turned right around.
Amen.
Because the power of God, he had to go.
That's right.
Amen. God will put it before us. God would put it, that test.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
You know, he will bring it, and it's to make us stronger.
Amen.
He will cause some kind of confusion to make us even tough. All right? Because, see, we got to stand. So he will stir up something, amen, that we could learn how to be strong.
Amen.
And stand like that tree, I'm going there again, planted by the rivers of the water.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Now, if we had a listen to the Lord 3 years ago, amen, when God was saying, boys would not be exempt.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Remember that?
Yes, sir.
When the Lord said a long time ago, when he said a long time ago that Boston will not be a jump, that means we're going to get it too. Oh, we got it. And now we're going to have to deal with it. His way. God's way. Amen.
Amen.
I'm almost through. Amen.
The lips of the wise disperse knowledge, but the heart of fools do not so.
The lips of the wise. Now, oh God, trust God. The lips of the wise. That's like a parable. The lips of the wise. Your mouth can be wise. It can be full of knowledge. It can be full of this. Amen. It can be filled with so much knowledge on the lips. Like I'm going to say, like some preachers. I got to go that way.
Amen.
They stand up and go and really preach down and get down to the nitty gritty. I mean, just preaching. Amen. We just are preaching. I mean, just are preaching. And the sweat be coming on now. And then you have to be a preaching. And then they get up, they walk in front of the church. And then they say this and they sit up. I mean, they be getting down. I mean, they be preaching.
The lips of the wise disperse knowledge.
The lips of the wise that give out knowledge. Now, you see, this is the word of God. Giving out knowledge. And you think they have so much knowledge because all those powerful words coming out. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, and they're speaking so nice and dropping every T and everything.
Say,
amen.
Say.
And just go ahead and everything and every P. Just pronouncing your words so correctly. All that knowledge, all that wisdom of man, all that wisdom. Amen?
Amen.
Go ahead.
But the heart of foolish, but the heart of the foolish do not so.
And can be just as foolish, 1, 2, 3.
Amen.
Can have that foolish, can have both of them.
Exactly.
God can put both of them in there. Can have both of them. Can have the knowledge, and boy, I have met many of them.
Amen.
Knowledge, but the power of a foolish heart.
Amen.
Not of God. And people will run to them. That's a deceiver of the enemy. They will run and humble themselves to their food. Amen. And the Holy Ghost be talking to them and be saying, don't trust him.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost said, trust me.
Amen.
He be saying, trust me. He said, don't do that. Don't go there. Don't go there. A deceiving spirit is there. Yes. Amen. Mm-hmm. But because of his title,
amen.
Because of his title, amen, he got to be right. Yes. Because of his word, I just know he's right. The scripture speaks of all that.
Yes.
And God warned us, and he told us to beware of the false prophet.
Yes. Amen.
You might see one over to the east, and they say, come over here. Then you might go and see one over to the west, and they say, come over here. And they might see one to the north. Amen. And then you'd be running back and forth, and another false prophet.
Amen.
Because we've been in that dispensation right now. Yeah. Amen. God will let you know who is real.
Amen.
And who is phony. But the Holy Ghost, not the flesh. If you live by the flesh, you will die by the flesh. Amen?
Amen.
We have to live by the Spirit of God.
That's right.
Not by the flesh. You got to live by the Spirit. That's who leads us, the Holy Ghost. And he is great and he is mighty. Amen. Go to 1 Corinthians. Amen. Amen. He's going to go to 1 Corinthians. Amen. Amen. You want an evangelist tiger to be a friend? Just sit down. Amen. Start with the 16th verse. Read the 16th verse.
And I baptize also the house of Stephanas. Besides, I know not whether I baptize any other.
Amen.
For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ shall be made of none effect.
Okay, we're talking about Paul. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's a like a sweaty brags. It's a bragging spirit. I do this here.
Amen.
You know how now Paul he didn't brag now. He was not like that, but I gotta use it as that. That's for Lord to use it. Read it again.
For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect.
Amen. And that's also a parable. Okay. God ordained Paul. He was terrible. Before the Lord saved him, he was really terrible. Killing Christian and all, he was terrible. But God saved him.
Amen.
And God saved him. And he gave him a title, the apostle. But he had order, and there were certain things that he could not do. Amen. He told him that he could not baptize people. He don't baptize people. Because people was coming to him, want him to baptize them. And he told him he don't baptize people. Amen. Now they look at Paul, that Paul was stupid. Who would he think that he don't baptize people? He ain't no better than nobody else. Amen.
Amen.
No, he was being obedient to the Lord.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Just being obedient to the Lord.
Right.
Now, when you tell somebody that God don't want you to do this, don't want you to do that, and you start telling that spirit that they think that you think so much and so this and so that,
amen.
Amen. And they be as far off as 1, 2, 3.
Amen.
If not that you think that you this and think you that,
right.
God has told you what to do and what not to do.
Amen.
Amen. And you better not do it.
Amen.
Amen. He hadn't told you what to do and what not to do.
Amen.
And we have people in our church just like that.
Amen.
Some know it, a whole lot of them don't know it. When the Lord tells you to do something, amen, no matter what it is, you have to do it.
Amen.
But when God tells you, I don't want you to do it, amen, you don't do it. You don't do it. But sometimes, that what you are not ordained to do,
amen.
God will allow you to do it because of certain situations.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. He call me Dr. Baptist. I am baptized, not one person since. God always has somebody else to baptize them. Because he told me that I cannot baptize people. I cannot. And when time for baptism, he will always have bishop and the bishop in Atlanta to come together and baptize them.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Now, I'm also, he had called me not to do funerals. But in that situation, sometimes I have to humble God want me to do funerals. Now, see, this is the difference. You have to know God.
Exactly.
Know him. Because he told me from the beginning what I was going to do and what I